Welcome back to Post Time. You don't have to travel to California to see stars. Right here in Dover, Delaware, the biggest and brightest talent can be seen this month. I'm here with Bob Stort. He's the trainer of Ultimate Cameron, and she's in the three-year-old trotting filly elimination for the matron. I just got to tell you, okay, I of course knew about Ultimate Cameron because she's raced so well this year, but I didn't feel like I knew enough before the interview. Let me tell you, this is why technology is so incredible. I took my phone and I looked her up and I like found out all this information because like when it comes to technology, I'm just totally illiterate. Now I'm like an Ultimate Cameron genius, you know. So her mom, Cameron Hall. Oh my gosh, that it wasn't hitting me until I looked it up on my phone.
Yeah, Cameron Hall was the 2 and 3 year old champion, and she made more money as a 2 and 3 year old than any other filly up to that time. She made like $1.7 million. And I was just thinking driving over here, this is the first time I've been back since 2004 when her mother won here.
So you had Cameron Hall and you had now you have Ultimate Cameron. How do you get lucky enough to get horses like that? And like the trotting fillies. I love me some trotting fillies.
Well, we were very lucky that we got Cameron Hall with Mr. Locke, and then Diamond Creek bought Ultimate Cameron when she was a yearling from Mr. Lockenden, and I was fortunate enough for them to ask me to train her.
Now, is the mommy like the daughter like the mommy, you know?
Stature-wise and stuff, they're very similar, and they're very similar gated.
Having a stake season like that, how do you keep them fresh? Because even though she hasn't won every race, she's done really well this year, and she's always like right there.
Well, she has had a very consistent year. I'd say she was fresher in some starts than others, but we gave her some time off after Lexington, and I'm hoping that she can finish with a bang.
Okay, speaking of finishing with a bang, so tonight you're in the elimination, you got to get top four. How do you feel about your competition and what's she going to be like tonight?
Well, you know, on paper it looks like she's in the easier of the two divisions. Some of the tougher fillies I think are in the other division, but I think it's not so much with Ultimate Cameron. If Ultimate Cameron races well, it doesn't really matter who she races against, and if she doesn't race well, kind of the same thing. So it's pretty much up to Ultimate Cameron. If she shows up and races well, she'll be fine.
Thank you so much for being on the show and good luck tonight.
I appreciate the opportunity.
In her matron elim, Ultimate Cameron made a bobble at the start and didn't make the final, but there will still be a group of talented three-year-old trotting fillies taking center stage in that matron final. Okay, the horse we're going to talk about now is Wishing Stone. He's in the three-year-old trotting colt division for the matron. And with me now is Dwayne Miner, who is major in talent. I've been waiting to say that all day long. All right. First of all, Dwayne, tell me about how you got into horse racing, because it's not like your typical story, right?
No, it's not. I got in it because of my dad. We used to go horseback riding when we were kids. And one day it come up, I think I was about between 8 and 11. Hey, Dad, let's get our own horse. He says, hey, I got a better one yet. Let's get a racehorse. I say, hey, cool. I say, we've never done that before. He said, that way you guys can earn a little money and take care of it and have your riding horse also. All right, and that's how we got started.
All right. Yeah. Oh, we should mention, you are not from the first state. You are from Michigan, is that right?
That's correct, yeah.
Big smile. Do you know a guy named Vince Copeland?
Oh, yes, I know him and his dad.
Do you want to tell me any secrets about them while we've got you on camera, because they're here now in Delaware? Anything you want to share?
No, they're good people, you know. I've had a lot of fun racing with them over the years. I've been friends with them for many years, and we raced the Michigan Fair Circuit. And they're great people. Yeah.
We were looking for more something like on the National Enquirer level, but that's okay too. All right, now we'll talk about.
I can go a little, no.
Yeah. All right, we'll talk about Wishing Stone now. Robert, my camera guy, take a look at this horse. Okay, little. Look at I'm like almost as tall as this horse. All right. Little horse, big heart.
Little horse, big heart, big will to race. Loves his work.
You know, you would think, like, when you were getting him, like, training him down and everything when he was a baby, did you, like, look at him and say, this horse is a total squirt. He's never going to make it.
No, you know, you can't measure what's inside. So you got to give the benefit of the doubt a lot of times with horses. Not that your big horses aren't fast horses, so you get a lot of speed a lot of times from your smaller horses. Sometimes they're not able to carry it, but this guy can do them both.
Good point. And that brings us to the Kentucky Futurity. Now, a lot of people surprise that he won that race. We want to mention Kentucky Futurity. It's raced in Lexington, and you have to win two races in one day, okay? Now, I was a little bit surprised. George Brennan, the driver, says he was not surprised. What were your feelings?
Oh, I wasn't either. You know, I knew he had it in him right along. It just, all year we've been getting bad posts and not really drawing well, getting away bad, such as that, but such is life with racing. Finally got a chance to draw in, and he got a chance to show what he can do. So that's what happened.
All right, so tonight is the elimination. You actually only have one horse to beat, so you got to be feeling pretty good that you're going to make the final, right?
Well, you know, anything can happen, but I think we'd be good.
Okay, all right. He's not going to disclose any more information except, yeah, he's looking forward to the final next week. Well, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Wishing Stone won his elimination in 153 and impressively, with George Brennan driving. Look for Wishing Stone in his matron final. So come out and see this bona fide superstar in the sport. Now, here's the deal with the matron finals taking place at Dover Downs. Tonight, Sunday, November 14th, these rich and historic events take place for the three-year-old Philly Trotters, the Philly Pacers, and the Colt Trotters. You don't want to miss them. But you may be wondering, what about the three-year-old Pacing Colts? Very nice observation. Also tonight, Sunday, November 14th, the $350,000 Progress Pace Final, Dover Downs' signature race, will go behind the gate, and that's the event that will feature the best three-year-old pacing colts in the sport. Don't forget, in honor of the Progress Pace, there will be a hat giveaway, so come out for your free Progress Pace baseball cap. So we've covered some stakes action happening tonight, but there is a live racing 6 nights a week at Dover Downs. Here's the schedule for the 2010-2011 meet. Monday through Thursday, the post time's at 4:30 p.m. Saturday and Sunday, the post time's at 5:30 p.m. And while I have your attention, let's also talk about the simulcasting action. The Dover Downs Race and Sportsbook features simulcasting of Major Harness and Thoroughbred Racing 7 days a week, from 12 noon until 12 midnight. It's also the place to take in all the professional sporting events from around the country. And don't forget, there's always free parking and free admission at Dover Downs. Just call 302-674-4600 for more information, or visit them on the web at doverdowns.com.